Hi, my name is Larry Calkins. I'm an artist here in the Pacific Northwest, and I'm here at the Kirkland Arts Center, and I'm demonstrating some tips on how to do a technique called trace monotype. It's a form of drawing with where you ink up a plate with some oil paint, in my case, and then you put a piece of paper on top of it, and then you draw on the back of the paper, and when you're done, you peel the paper off of the inked up plate, and then that's your drawing. A piece of paper or a sketchbook, like this, like a Leda sketchbook. A piece of plexiglass that's about the same size as your sketchbook. Some oil paint, and this is Gumbacher, German oil paint, but it could be anything. A brayer. And a pencil. So let me demonstrate here. First of all, I take just a little bit of oil paint, and I roll that onto a piece of plexiglass with a brayer. This is a brayer. Until I get it nice and smooth and even. I like this technique because it doesn't require a lot of materials. Something you could travel with, and doesn't take up a lot of space in your luggage. And then once it's oiled up, you can see there's a nice thin layer of oil paint on the surface. In the sketchbook, I just put it between the pages, and then I draw on the back. In this case, the drawing is on the front of the sketchbook, but. But the actual drawing that I want, that I'm interested in, is going to be on the back. So, and then I just basically draw with a pencil. In this case, very crude elephant, I think. I could add shading. I can use my finger to kind of add a little shading if I want. Add some modeling around the edge. It's a little plate tone, it's called. You can add a little, circus tent in the background. Some clouds, the sun. And then when you turn it over, you have a nice drawing that's a lot more interesting than the pencil drawing. So it's nice because it kind of gives you this sort of this etching that that maybe you've made a plate and you've done all the acid and stuff, but it's sort of a poor man's version of that, I guess. But I like the way it looks, and it's also spontaneous, and it takes the artist out of the equation a little bit, which is sometimes a good thing. You know, sometimes that bit of accident really enhances a piece of work. You're sort of kind of working with nature and your own pencil at the same time, and I like that. I always like to have a little bit of the unknown when I'm making work.
What about putting color on?
So if I wanted to color this, I use watercolor. I didn't bring my watercolors today, but it's nice because the oil acts as a resist. So I could put a wash over this and wherever the oil is, it's not going to stick. But wherever there's no oil, it will actually add color. So it's really nice to work with watercolor. And of course, I really like these. I like the Leda sketchbook paper, which I've mentioned that before, because of the softness, and it takes watercolor in a nice way. The nice thing about drawing like this, because it takes you out of it, you don't become so hypercritical about what you're doing, you know. So by doing this technique, like I said, it takes you out of the equation a little bit, and so you can be a lot more spontaneous, because you can't wait to see what's going to happen next. It's almost like somebody else is drawing the picture, and I like that. So today we've covered trace monotype, which is basically oiling up a piece of plexiglass, putting a piece of paper on top of that, or putting it between the pages of your sketchbook, making a drawing that is a lot like an etching. And next time we will cover a different technique.